بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I pray that you're all well, brothers and sisters. And this reminder, I believe all of us are in need of this reminder. So this reminder for myself first and foremost and all those listening. يقول الله عز وجل في محكم تنزيله ولقد يسرنا القرآن للذكر فهل من مدكر. Allah states in his noble book in Surah Al-Qamar that we have made the Quran easy for one to recite and to remember. Is there any of those that will take heed and utilize and recite this Quran? Is there any that will take heed? And in the tafsir of Ibn Kathir, he mentions الَّذِي يُرِيد أو مَنْ أَرَاد, meaning the one that wishes, the one that wants. And As-Siddi and Qatada, they mentioned and they said, meaning the one that wants to seek knowledge and to seek the understanding of this Quran. And when they explain this verse, they say that meaning we have made it easy. And Allah mentions and He says, وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ, meaning we have made it easy to recite upon the tongue and also for one to remember and to memorize. So is there any that will take heed? Is there any that's out there who wants to learn this Quran? So ask yourself, Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, do you really want to read the Quran? Do you really want to memorize? Because wallahi, it is not difficult. It doesn't matter your age, your race, your situation. And we have seen many proofs of this. Those that were illiterate, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the best of examples, he memorized the Quran. He was able to read the Quran when he was taught by Jibreel alayhi salam. So for those that say that I cannot read, there is no excuse. We have seen many people that are blind. They were able to memorize the whole Quran. People that had a disability. So subhanAllah, ask yourself really, what excuse do I have? Is it the Arabic language? That's not an excuse. If you're able to attain that which you've attained in the dunya, from knowledge, from qualifications, positions, whatever it could be that you have today, you did it through hardship. No one woke up and became where they are or have been able to possess what they possess to the stage that they're at today except through hard work. Ya ikhwani, the Quran is not difficult. Ya ikhwani wa akhawati, the Quran is not difficult. Just pick up the Quran, take time and read and recite and memorize and learn. Maybe you do have a difficulty in reciting the Arabic language, but what is it for there? What is it there for you? Why should you go through that difficulty? كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, as that which he has is mentioned in the hadith, he says, والذي يقرأ القرآن ويتتعتع فيه, the one that recites the Quran and he stutters and he finds it difficult by stuttering upon reciting the Quran, وهو عليه شاق فله أجران. الله أكبر. The one that recites the Quran and he is struggling and he is stuttering, but with so he finds it difficult. So if you're from these people that you stutter, maybe you're not an Arab. Maybe you are finding it difficult learning the Arabic language. Maybe it's difficult for you to learn the huruf, the Arabic alphabets. Then remember, whenever you recite the Quran, you're not going to get one reward, that which a normal person will get that doesn't have any difficulty. You're going to get two rewards. So there is no excuse. Utilize that reward that is there. It's up for grabs. Read the Quran. Read the Quran. Don't be from those that have taken their time in speaking about others, in memorizing and learning about celebrities, football players, you name it. Read the Quran. It's the salvation. As Allah states in His noble book, إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَمْ وَيُبَشِّرِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ الصَّالِحَاتِ. This Quran, this is what it's for. It guides the people to the right path, as Allah mentions in the Quran. It's a means of guidance. Ya ikhwani, think about it. There is nothing, nothing that we need in our lives. Doesn't matter where you're from, whatever you need in your life, the solution is the Quran and the Sunnah. The Quran, read it, recite it, ponder and reflect upon the Quran. That is what it was made for. As Al-Imam Al-Ajurri, rahimahullah, he mentions, he said, for me, it is more beloved for me to recite a little from the Quran, but ponder upon it, than to recite a lot meaning to read pages and pages and pages and to not have any understanding or reflection or admonition. So read the Quran, and remember, when you read it, you will be rewarded. What is the proof? كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet ﷺ mentions in the hadith, and he states, والذي يقرأ القرآن يوم القيامة, meaning on the day of judgment, the one that used to recite the Quran, فإنه يأتي شفيعا لأصحابه. The Quran will come as an interceder. It will intercede for you. It will make shafa'a for you. It will intercede for you in يوم القيامة. إخواني وأخواتي, every single one of us shall taste death. Every single one of us will be resurrected and will stand in front of our Lord Jalla Jalalu. Are you ready to stand in front of Allah? Have you read the Quran enough? Have you understood the Quran? Have you implemented it in your life? This is what the reason the Quran is. Remember, the Quran is literally like a manuscript. It's like a manual guide. It's a guidance. Think of it like this, and this example I think will touch home. When you buy a new gadget, an appliance, whatever it could be, there's instructions, a manual, a guide. You follow the instructions in order to put that specific gadget together. Without it, you'll be lost. If you have no experience, you'll be lost. And at the back of it, there's a number. If you can't follow those instructions, you're not capable in doing so, then you have a number there. Now think of the Quran as a means and a guidance. It's that manuscript in order how to live your life, how one should be as a human being, the boundaries, the limits, what you can and can't do in your life, how you should be as a person, your morals, your characteristics. This is how you should see the Quran. It's a means of guidance from Allah Jalla Jalalu. If you get stuck, you're not able to recite it, you don't know, ask those of knowledge. فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Ask. If you don't have the knowledge, if you don't know, ask the people of knowledge. Those that مختصين بالقرآن, those that specialize in the Quran, the ulama, the scholars. This is what the deen is. It's simple. But learn the Quran, read it. This reminder for myself first and foremost, and I hope inshallah it's of benefit. Read the Quran. Don't waste your time. If you have companions that are taking you away from reading the Quran, maybe you want to learn. Start today. Don't make any excuse. Don't say, I'm busy, I got work, I got 4 kids. Yeah, ikhwani, people start at the age of 16 to memorize the Quran. And there's a story of a man who started at the age beyond. He was beyond the 50s. He wanted to learn and seek knowledge. He wanted to read the Quran. And what did he do? He signed up for an institution to learn the Quran. And within 6 months to a year, he memorized the whole Quran. Yeah, ikhwani, it's not difficult. Don't make excuses. Don't lie to yourself. Don't lie to yourself. You can do it. You can memorize the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. It is not difficult. What's the proof? وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِنْ مُدَّكِرِ. It will be, maybe in the beginning, difficult. Like anything. You go to university. Is it easy in the beginning? A-levels, GCSEs, work, whatever it could be, businesses. You fail and you fail. But what is the best type of person that is successful? The one that is ready to accept failure. If you are ready to fail, meaning if you're already in that business to fail, then inshallah you'll be from the successful ones. So if you're ready to read the Quran knowing that it can and it will be difficult in the beginning, maybe your tongue will not be used to sitting down memorizing. And there's many tips, but this video is just a message to read and memorize the Quran and understand it and implement it in your life. In the beginning, it may be difficult reading the Quran. It could be tough. It takes sleepless nights maybe. Maybe it could be just, oh, I can't do it. You want to give up? Don't give up. In the beginning, it could be difficult. But when you think of it as like a line, in the beginning is difficult. Ups and, you know, bumpy, it's going to be bumpy. Bumpy road, bumpy journey. It's going to be difficult. But when you get to the end, wallahi, you look back and be like, Alhamdulillah, alladhi manna Allahu alayya an ahfadhu al-Quran. Alhamdulillah, praise you to Allah for allowing me, enabling me to be able to memorize this Quran. Because there is nothing like it. And you'll be able to have a relationship with your Lord better. Especially if you learn and memorize and understand. And remember, when you learn the Quran, that will be something that you will be able to know you accomplished something in this world. There is nothing better than reading the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. It's not created. It's not from mankind. It's from Allah Jalla Jalal. His words. And I'll end on a hadith. كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقال لأصحاب القرآن. Meaning, it will be said to the one that used to recite the Quran in this dunya. So think, What are you reading? What are you uttering? I'm pretty sure many of you have completed novels, movies, comedies, series. How much of the Quran have you actually read? Forget memorizing. Ask yourself that question. How many times in a day, does a day go by where you read the Quran, or does a day go by where you miss reading the Quran? I'm talking about outside of Salah. How many times do you just pick up the Mus'haf and read? So it will be said to the one that used to recite the Quran, Iqra. It will be said to him, Yawm al-Qiyamah, meaning read, Wartaqi, Warattil, Kama kunta turattil fi dunya. It will be said to him, read, ascend, and recite the way you used to recite in this worldly life. فَإِنَّ مَنْزِلَكَ, because verily your final abode, your place that you would be, عِنْدَ آخِرِ آيَةٍ تَقْرَأُهَا, it will be the last. It will be what? What will be your final abode? What will be your place? What will be your place in Jannah? It will be the last ayah that you recited in this dunya. Allahumma ja'alna min ahli al-Qur'an. Allahumma ja'alna min ahli al-Qur'an. May Allah Azza wa Jal make us from the people that recite the Qur'an and take it as a companion where we recite the Qur'an, and try and keep a mushaf in your pocket somewhere when you're traveling on the plane. Many of us, we travel on the plane, we're like, what did I forget? My luggage, did I forget this? Maybe some of us have children. Did I bring the medication? Did I bring his clothes? Did I bring the camera? How many of us say, did I take my mushaf with me? How many of us remember the Quran? How many of us? Ask yourself this, subhanAllah. How many of us remember to bring the Quran with us when we're traveling on a plane, 8 hours, 6 hours? You don't have to read the whole Quran on the plane, just read a page. At least you know that you spent some time pondering upon the verses of your Lord Jalla Jalalu. How many of us, we go to certain places, we'd never forget our phones, Instagram, we never forget to post or to tweet. We never forget to read or to follow or read up what someone is doing. We never forget to follow other people's uyub, other people's mistakes. But yet, are we looking at ourselves, trying to better ourselves with the Quran? Because no, as Aisha radiallahu anha was asked, how is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam with regards to his mannerisms? What does she respond? What does she say? She said, أَخْلَاقُهُ Quran. His mannerism is the Quran, meaning that which is in the Quran, that's how he's like. Sallallahu alayhi wasallam. May Allah make us from those that tried to be like him. Sallallahu alayhi wasallam. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. هذا وصلى الله وسلم على العالمين. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.